Mamá.
Ay, pero voy a limpiar después, acabo de limpiar. No hay nadie.
Good evening, good evening. Hi, everyone. Hello, hello, Milagro. Hi, Adita. Luz, hello, good evening. How are you?
Fine, thank you. And you?
I'm okay. Everything good so far? Hi. Hi there. How are you girls?
Fine. Thank you, teacher.
Uy, ¿qué está pasando here? Okay. ¿Me escuchan? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, super good. So everyone, good evening. Thank you very much for joining today's class. Happy Friday. Okay, I hope you had a really good day. ¿Cómo estuvo su Friday? How was your Friday? Was it good? Was it so easy, difficult? Tell me, ¿cómo estuvo su Saturday? I mean, su Saturday, su Friday.
My Friday fine.
Your Friday was fine, okay. Ada, how was your Friday? Recuerdo que dijo que era pesadito. Fridays are difficult. How was today? Good. You're mute. Sorry, you're mute.
Good day.
Ah, it was a good day. So no estuvo muy pesado. It was not too difficult.
No.
Ah, okay. I'm happy to hear that. Okay. Avilene, hello. Doris, what about you? What about your day? How was that?
My Friday was very good.
Nice. Okay. So, everybody, I'm really happy that you're having a nice Friday. Espero que you know, if you have to work tomorrow, que sea like nice, easy, not too difficult. And I'm really happy to see you today, all right? And thank you very, very much. Hi, Madeline, how are you doing? Fatima, hello, how are you doing? So, espero que hayan tenido un super nice day. And if you are sick, that you get over soon. Que estén super ready, like super, super soon. Okay. And so, vamos a disfrutar dos horitas here of our Friday. So, espero que we practice like a lot, you know. Terminamos que casi estamos a una semana. We are a week away from finishing. Así que let's do our best to get ready for level number 3. And let me just share here. So, les comparto mi pantalla. Let me share my screen right here. Girls, ¿qué se recuerdan de la clase de ayer? What do you remember? Tell me. New vocabulary. ¿Alguna palabra que hayan aprendido? Any new word? ¿Algo que se recuerden? Ada, tell me, ¿qué palabra se recuerda de ayer? What word do you remember from yesterday?
Continuamos con el present continuous, ¿no?
Yes.
Siempre el uso del ing, ¿verdad?
Ajá, yes.
También el uso de palabras como when, where, why, who.
Ajá, yes.
Which. Ayer, por ejemplo, yo no sabía que era live.
Ay, nice. Ajá. ¿Y qué significa? What does it mean, Ada?
O sea, que era levantar, ¿verdad? Pero nosotros lo usamos con Andrés en la conversación, en caso de un elevador, y nos quedamos con esa pequeña duda. ¿verdad? Porque uh-huh. nos íbamos a reunir, si usted se recuerda.
Sí.
Nos íbamos a reunir para ver los avances, se supone, dentro de la conversación. Uh-huh. Los avances dentro de la compañía que dije que era nuestra.
Claro.
¿Verdad? Entonces, al final quedamos que nos íbamos a reunir en un lugar y, e íbamos a abordar el ascensor o a subir por el ascensor uh-huh. y ahí nos quedamos, ¿verdad?
Okay,
porque okay. teníamos When Are You Meeting
yeah.
en Torre Futura and the Second Flower You Take a Deep Leaf. Ahí nos, ah, te, okay. nos quedamos en ese pequeño que ya quizás no tuvimos oportunidad de participar porque ya era el tiempo.
Sí, estábamos
corto.
En la hora, exacto.
Entonces, no. Pensamos que estaba bien usado ahí esta, esa pequeña palabra.
De hecho, sí. Actually, yes, Ada. Quizás es como no tan común en well, depende del país donde usted vaya. Puede que a veces no le entiendan la palabra lift porque es uh-huh. más como de Europa, ¿verdad? Pero sí. está bien. Entonces, if it's like, I will see okay. you at the lift. Está súper bien. I think it's super okay. good. Because okay. lo está usando como elevator. O también cuando okay. se dice, cuando se maneja maquinaria también dice, you can lift. Y dice cuántas libras. Ajá. So, okay. También son como ambos usos. But yeah, it's totally fine. Yes, yes,
okay.
yes.
Okay, thank you, teacher.
No, thank you. Thank you for the question. I think it's super nice. Okay. I also see we got Sandra. Hello, Sandra. Guillermo. Hi, Guillermo. Nice to have you today. Luz. Hello, Luz. Thank you so much for joining and share, you know, with us a couple of minutes. And we are going to have a session number 14 today. That is October 9th. All right. So I got like some... Well, continuamos con present continuous, como Ada lo mencionó. We are going to continue with present continuous. Vamos a practicar questions, positive, negative. Today is going to be like a lot of practice. Tenemos reading también. Vamos a tener una pequeña reading que no hemos hecho reading so far. So we are going to go over your reading comprehension. Okay. And to get started, guys, les quiero mostrar mi vocabulario. I want to share some vocabulary que son parte de las cosas que vamos a estudiar today, right? Yesterday, ¿alguien se recuerda del vocabulario de ayer? Ada mencionó una que era lift, all right? What about the others, guys? ¿Qué más se recuerda? What do you remember?
Yo recuerdo la palabra improve.
Ah, very good, exactly. Yes, yes, nice. So the word improve. ¿Qué más? What else?
Lift.
Lift. Okay.
Advancing.
Advance. Yes, exactly. Advances. Ajá. Uh-huh. Improve. Yes. ¿Qué más? What else? Actually, though, that is very good vocabulary. Okay. Now, today, tenemos un par de palabras. For example, here, we have IT. Algunos están familiarizados con esto. You know what IT is, all right? Probably you don't, but okay. We got IT here. The second one is employer. So IT, employer, okay? The next one is launching. Launching, what is launching? Then we have hand, pero no hand de mano, right? No, van a ver que hand también tiene otro significado. So not this hand, but a different one, okay? And the last one that we have is staff. Okay, so here you have some sentences that I have selected. And you guys, what you gotta do is poner esas palabras. You have to place the words into the corresponding space. Okay, so I will give you 5 minutes. Si hay alguna palabra que desconozcan that is totally new for you, no worries. Podemos usar el diccionario. Check your dictionary. Check the meaning of the word. Probablemente la palabra lunch is gonna be new. Pero si les cuesta encontrarla, elimínele el ing y eso es todo. And you will find the meaning of the word. So I'll give you 5 minutes. Matchemos, please. Let's match the vocabulary with the corresponding word. Okay? 5 minutes.
Pero ¿y esa palabra I.T, teacher?
IT. That's IT. Es una abreviación. This is an abbreviation. guys, si encuentran algo que sea nuevo, if you find any word that is new, I would recommend you to Google it. You know, you can Google it, use your dictionary, para que ustedes vayan formando su propio life. Improving your vocabulary. That's a very good one. Mm-hmm. So, because maybe they are different from the ones that we know. So guys, let's go for it. 5 minutes. Hi, Francisco. Edith, good evening. Hello. Hi. Guillermo is here.
Hello, good evening.
Hello, hello, hello. Nice to have you today. You can take a picture. Siempre podemos tomar una foto de eso. You can take a screenshot here.
Verde.
All right, guys, so, si acabamos de entrar, we are just starting with the vocabulary section. Here, tenemos vocabulario que vamos a revisar ahora. We have some vocabulary here. And in yellow, we have some sentences. So, siempre vamos a hacer un matching, right? We are going to do a little matching here. Thank you. Hey, Cesar. Hello. Thank you for joining.
Hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Nice to have you today. How are you, Cesar?
I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay, nice to hear that. You know, escucho su voz, but no lo veo. I can see. Oh, I see you now. Okay. All right. También veo que ya está por acá, Cesar. I mean, Gerson. So, hello, Gerson. Good evening. Let me see. Sandra Patricia also. Good evening. Hello, hello. I see Christian also. Hi, Christian. Good evening. All right, guys. So, me confirman si les puedo dejar de compartir mi pantalla unos minutitos. Let me just, you can take a picture in the meantime. Pueden tomarle una captura. You can take a screenshot. I'm going to go over attendance. Les voy a dejar de compartir mi pantalla like some seconds here. Give me a second. Solamente voy a pasarles asistencia, like the first attendance that we always do. Nuestro primer control. today is the 9th. All right. Okay, guys, so help me please with your cameras and help me say present. So I got Fatima Lopez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Fatima. Aza?
Thank you. Present, teacher.
Thank you, Aza. No, you're good. It's okay. It's okay. But we listen to you, and that's important, porque no veo ahorita la pantalla. Guillermo Torres. Mr. Sí. Torres, hello, Mr. Torres, thank you so much. I have Christian.
Present.
Thank you, Christian. Isaac. Ya está por acá, Isaac. Quizás está en camino, right? Okay, so let me continue here. Luz Esquivel. Está por ahí, right? Yes, but maybe she has problems with the camera. Okay, Avilene. Avilene.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Avilene. Sandra Patricia.
Present.
Thank you. Edith.
Present.
Thank you, Edith.
No, quitar mute.
No se preocupe, no worries, no, así nos pasa, you know, tenemos a lot of things open. Silvia, do you see Silvia? Silvia here? Todavía no, right? Not yet. Okay.
Estoy en clase, déjame.
Voy a apagar mi cámara por apagar otra cosa, ok. Francisco Eduardo.
Present.
Thank you, Francisco. Sandra Beatriz.
Present.
Thank you, Sandra. Harrison.
Present.
Thank you. Madeline. Oh, Madeline no puede hablar, I believe.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Madeline. Thank you so much. Yes. Thank you so much. And thank you, Miss, for being here. Berito creo que dijo que venía en camino. Doris.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Doris. María Milagros.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Milagros. Jennifer.
Present.
Thank you. Thank you. Hey, hello, Miss. Good evening. Thank you for your attendance. Andrés creo que también iba en camino. And Cesar. Que escuché a César hace un par de minutos.
Present.
Thank you so much. Okay, guys. Nice. Excellent attendance, everybody. Gracias por compartir, you know, some minutes with the rest of us. And, well, so let's make the best that we can. ¿Terminaron el ejercicio? Did you finish the exercise? ¿Necesitan más tiempo? Do you need more time to complete it?
No.
Unos minutos, teacher.
Oh, okay, okay, no worries. I'll give you one more minute. In the meantime, we can check pronunciation, you know. O si ya terminamos, hagamos lo siguiente. Escribamos una oración extra, all right. Una oración adicional para que la podamos compartir as well. Especially, son palabras que usamos every single day in the company, like IT, you know, launching, we use them. But a veces no sabemos how to use them. Entonces podemos escribir una oración adicional. Y así mejoramos nuestro vocabulario as well.
Y esa última, teacher, una pregunta.
Yes, Milagro.
En la última donde dice vaquecho, es así la palabra.
No, thank you. That's not the word. Hold on. That was, okay, wait. I always show you the answer. Namis, hay un typo. Hay un error de dedo. Se me fue una letra. Hace falta una letra.
A tomar la captura de pantalla.
better. Así se fuerza. You effort a little bit more. Yeah, I always show you the answer. Okay, guys. So, ya vieron algunos. You already saw some of my answers. Otros, you were not ready, as you said. So, let's take a look at what we have here. Okay, so si la vieron, pretendan que no la vieron, okay? Let's take a look at the answers. IT, where can we use IT? In which of the sentences can we use IT?
The IT department solves issues slowly.
Yes, very good, exactly. The IT department, uh-huh. So they solve, or the IT department solves issues. What is the meaning of issue? Problem, okay. So when you say, I have a problem, problem suena como algo muy delicado. Entonces you can say, oh, I have some issues. Tengo problemas personales. I have some personal issues, okay, that I have to take care of, okay. Or I have some issues at work. Entonces, issue es como decir problema, okay? That's another way to say it. Now, IT department. IT, ¿encontraron the meaning of IT? Did you get this?
Information.
¿Tienen IT? Information technology. Mm-hmm. In your company, el IT son los encargados de las computadoras, fix technical problems, the engineers. IT in your company. Do you have IT?
Yes.
But it's regional department. It's not here.
Oh, it is not here. Not okay. Here is, so the IT department is not in the country.
Yeah. It's in the United States country.
It is in United States. Okay. Cesar?
In case is subcontratado. ¿Cómo se dice?
Like an outsourcing.
Okay. Outsourcing.
Okay.
Oh, it is an outsourcing.
Yes,
okay.
It is outsourcing.
Okay, it is an outsourcing. Mm-hmm. So that is the IT, los encargados de la computadora, you know, and everything related to that. Now, let's go for next one. Employer. What about employer?
The employer has the obligation
to pay
vacation. Ah, let's take a look. Yes, very good. And here, ese es mi error, right? Nos, me faltó una N acá. So, has the obligation to pay vacation. Exactly. Very good. So, Milagro, gracias por the comment here. Yes, I was typing too fast. Okay. Next one, let's take a look at this one, launching. Este está en el material. Every single thing that you see here está en lo que vamos a ver ahora. So, you can, if you have problems, you know, questions, issues with this, puede revisar el material y van a encontrar these words. So, launching. What about launching? ¿Dónde lo podemos usar?
Is launching the project this week.
Very good. Okay. And what is the meaning?
Como inaugurando. Inaugurando.
Ajá. Okay. Lanzando. Exactly. Lanzo. Exactly. Like starting. Okay. So the office is, or
the project is weak.
Mm-hmm. Or sometimes a company, like a company is launching a project, yeah, or the department, etc. Yes. Now we have. Okay, so that is the office is launching, right? Then we have hand. Hand can be this. But also hand tiene otro, there is another meaning, yeah? So what is the meaning here? Can you help me? This one? Hand?
¿Cómo entregar?
¿Cómo entregar? Si se recuerdan hace like 2-3 days, vimos la palabra handin, right? So here we have another example. So we got here, please hand the documents on time, all right? Like hand, okay, entregue, right? So hand the documents on time. And we have the last one that is staff. Obviously, the answer is more than... Exactly, exactly. So members of the staff have to be on time. Yes, very good. So everybody, are we okay with the vocabulary? Are we good?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, nice, nice, super, super good. So in that case, let's go and let's practice this vocabulary. So if you pay attention here, we have more, well, we have some of these words. I would like to have a, well, some volunteers to help me, okay, read this part. So remember, este está como it, pero no la película, right? So this one is IT. Lo pronunciamos separado, IT. So, this is the IT department. So let me have, I'm going to select some of our classmates. Let me have Hurston and Jennifer. Hey guys, can you please help me read the conversation? So Jennifer, can you help me with Rita's part? And Hurston, can you please help me with Luis' part?
Okay.
Thank you.
Luis. Good afternoon. This is Rita, the new secretary. I just want to confirm some information.
Hurston, are you there? I think he's still having some technical issues here. Cesar, can you please help me read the part of Luis? Thank you, Rita.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Rita. My goodness. Thank you, Cesar. I'm reading Rita. Okay. Thank you, Cesar. Go ahead.
Okay. Start again.
No, no, she already started here, so you can move on with it. Hey, Jennifer.
Hey, Jennifer. Sure, tell me.
I want to count who are attending the annual conference this year and where is taking place.
Where? The IT staff is attending and the conference is taking place in the great room. Jennifer, by the way, where are the materials arriving? Do you know?
Good evening. Yes, they arrive on Friday morning.
Thank you very much. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the words that we have. First, vamos a practicar un poquito de speaking and the pronunciation, right? So everybody, please, let's repeat. Sure.
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 IT staff.
IT staff. IT staff.
Arriving.
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 Got it.
Got it.
Got it.
So got it. It's like, oh, I got it. Okay, ya lo entendí. Okay, I got it. All right. So here we have like a little conversation and let's take a look at the questions that we have. Who are attending the annual conference this year? Where is it taking place? When are the materials arriving? Okay, so now let's try to answer some questions about this reading. So revisemos, let's take a look at this. We have just the conversation above to help yourself. So, help me, please. Ayúdeme. ¿Cuál es la palabra? What is the word that is missing en estos espacios? What is missing? Number one.
When.
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 When. Yes, when are the materials arriving? Very good. Number two. What do you have in number two?
Who?
Who? Very nice. Who is attending the conference?
Tiene frío. Venite.
So who is attending the conference? What about number three?
Where?
Where?
Where is the meeting taking place?
Where?
Ah, yeah, okay. Let's take a look. Where is the meeting taking place? Let's take a look. Where exactly? Where is it taking place? Very nice. So we have, when are the materials arriving? Very good, guys. Very, very nice. ¿Estamos bien hasta acá? Are you good so far?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Okay. Yes. Very good. So in that case, let's just try, you know, to have a very similar conversation to the one that we have right here. So vamos a ir a practicar esta conversación super short, probably just 5 minutes. Okay. Intentemos practicar estos sonidos que son como un poquito más difíciles, como el sure, got it, sure, you know, para que sonemos más natural, right? Remember here, esta de acá tiene una K al inicio, but remember that no la pronunciamos. We say no, I want to know, I want to know, and that's it. So, you can take a picture, okay, you can take a screenshot. Y si tienen el material, you can use the material, definitely. We are going to practice this conversation. Si ustedes pueden hacer los cambios, that would be super good. For example, got it, they are arriving on, and en vez de decir Friday, you can say they are arriving next Monday, next Tuesday, next Wednesday, okay? Or here, for example, podemos hacer cambios. Good afternoon, this is Rita, the new administrative assistant, the new coordinator, etc. You can make changes, okay? Feel free to make changes and use your vocabulary. Ready? ¿Estamos claros lo que vamos a hacer? Yes? Sandra? Yes? Fátima?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, very nice. Good, 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 guys. So in that case, let's get started. Let's get started. Wait. Okay, so let's start. We are going to make some groups here super quick. And yeah, this is great. So everybody, I'm sending you the invitation and there you go. Everybody, let's go to the groups. You have 5 minutes, practice, and then you come back.
Well, this is that the AT staff is attending and the conference is taking place in the great room. Rita, by the way, when are the materials arriving? Do you know?
Get up. Go eat. Yes, they are arriving on Friday morning.
Ok. Si quiere, entonces cambiamos y luego los modificamos. Sandrita.
Ok.
Yo soy ahora Rita y ahora ustedes Luis.
Bueno.
¿Sí?
Sí.
Ok. Luis, good afternoon. This is Rita, the new secretary. I just want to confirm some information.
Hey, Rita, sure, tell me.
Así y después le damos, lo volvemos a practicar.
Ok, vamos con César entonces. César, good afternoon. This is Fatima, the new secretary, I just want to confirm some information.
Hello,
teacher.
Hi, Milagro. I'm so sorry, Milagro. No me fijé que estaba con Madeline. What happened is
que Madeline no puede hablar.
Sí, exacto, exacto. I totally forgot about it. Hasta ahorita que la veo. No se preocupe, ahorita la muevo para otro grupo.
Gracias.
She can just listen. No worries.
Hello. Yes, ¿ya lo tienes?
Okay, okay. Yes, yes.
Okay. Guys. Hi, hi, teacher.
Hello. Hi, guys. I have sent Jennifer and Madeline to your group. Madeline solo va a escucharlos, but you are more than welcome to you know go ahead and practice. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Jennifer.
I am here.
This is este es Rita, dice, ¿verdad?
Yeah, yes. Sí, así solo léalo.
Ajá. The new secretary. I just want to confirm some information.
Hey, Rita. Sure, tell me.
I want to know. We are attending the annual conference this year, and where is it taking place?
Repítalo, Milagro.
I want to know.
No.
No.
Uh-huh.
I want to know.
Yes.
Who are attending
who are attending
the annual conference this year,
yes.
And where is it taking place?
Okay, well, the IT staff is attending and the conference is taking place in the great room. Rita, by the way, what are the material arriving? Do you know?
Got it. Yes, they are arriving on Monday morning.
Okay, excelente.
Thank you guys for coming back. Solo les damos un par de minutitos a quienes faltan. Wait a second. Okay, guys, so give me just a second. Let me confirm. Let me check. Yeah, I think I got everybody here. Okay, very nice. Thank you so much for coming back, guys. Let's move on a little bit and let's practice the following part, that is just questions. Ayer veíamos un poquito de las WH words, and today we have some exercises using these WH words. So yesterday, for example, veíamos un poquito de what, when, where, why, which, okay, how, and here today, tenemos como un poquito más de ejercicios. Siempre vamos a recordar que si me preguntas why, mi respuesta es because. Tengo que dar una explicación. Oh, sorry. So why is the meeting, why is he meeting the new people today? Because he doesn't have time another day, because he is busy, because etc. When is the new office launching? So when, me está pidiendo el día, right? On Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday. Where? ¿Cuáles podrían ser las posibilidades? Where is your boss having the annual meeting? Give me possibilities. Where is your boss having the annual meeting? ¿Qué podemos decir? What, how can you answer this? In the park? In a hotel?
Any convention other? Center?
In the convention center. Thank you. Mm-hmm. What else? Thank you, Madeline. Exactly. In a hotel. That can be another possibility. Okay, guys. So here, vamos a trabajar un poquito con el ejercicio 4. It says, fill the blanks using the words in parentheses. So vamos a usar lo que usted tiene acá. You work, he divide, he hand, your boss visit, the new secretary work, para completar esas preguntas. Okay. So I will give you 5 minutes. Yeah, I think I will give you like around 5 minutes. Intentemos completarlas, ok. You can write them on your notebook. Las pueden escribir en el chat si se sienten cómodos doing it. Me las pueden mandar solo a mí. I mean, you're totally fine with that. So let's go for it. 5 minutes.
Está esa, teacher, está esa lámina en el manual.
Sí, miss, ahí está en el manual.
Ya le confirmo. Page number 36.
Thank you very much.
Ah, ya le encontré.
Two more minutes.
Dime. La USB.
Ah, no, no, la otra.
No va a estar.
Okay, everybody, are you finished? Do you need more time? 1 minute, 2 minutes?
Don't, teacher.
Don't, thank you, Cesar. Hey guys, I'm checking some of your sentences. No se nos olvide, porfa, que es importante agregar el verbo to be, okay? So, are, is, am. Siempre debemos agregárselo. That's like super, super important. Okay, everybody. So, let's take a look at your sentences.
Don.
Thank you. Thank you, Doris. Very nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, everybody, so let's take a look at what we have here. Number one says, what company are you working for? Okay, so como ahorita, what company are you working for? Sorry, okay. Number two, let's take a look at number two. How? Number two, Milagro, ¿qué tiene la segunda? What do you have in the second? How? Milagro, can you hear me? Oh, there you go. Okay.
Oh, yo no sé si está bien, pero
no se
yo
preocupe.
Puse
go.
How are he dividing the groups?
Okay, very good. Repítame lo primero que agregó. How?
How are?
¿Y después?
He.
Okay. Revisemos la number two. Tenemos he. Okay. Y tenemos tres formas del verbo to be. Am, is, and are. Si tenemos he, ¿cuál utilizamos?
Is.
Okay. Entonces, how is he dividing the groups? Exactly. So, vayamos revisando la que la tenemos similar, right? Number three. Let's take a look at number three. I got Guillermo. What do you have in number three, Guillermo?
When is she handed the chip?
Excellent. Thank you very much. Number four, Avilena, do you have number four? Which factory?
Which factory is your boss visiting this month?
Excellent, that's very good. And I got, let me see. I got. Okay, Christian, no sé si me escucha. I don't know if you can listen to me now. Do you have number five, Christian? Maybe he's not. Okay. Ava, do you have number five?
Why is he the new secretary working the next Saturday?
Excellent. Why is the new secretary working? Okay. Yes, excellent, excellent.
The next meeting next Monday.
Oh, okay. Okay. That's good. So you have the answer also. Okay, nice. That's very, very good. All right, give me just a quick second here. Berito, hi, Vero. Ya veo que nos acompaña. Hello, thank you so much. Pudo a pesar de todo, right? You could do it.
Hasta en otra clase estuve.
What? ¿Por qué? Why?
Me ayudaron de soporte técnico, pero me dieron otro link y fue a dar a la clase de otro profesor.
Oh, le dieron otro código.
Ajá.
Ah, ok.
Se confundieron.
Pero lo importante es que ya está acá, that you're back here. No, I was texting you because I was like, you know, quería saber qué había pasado with that, but I'm super happy that you are here. So no se vaya con otro profesor. Don't leave me. Don't leave me alone. Okay, guys. So let's see.
Teacher.
Yes, yes, Sandra.
Disculpe, ¿puede repetir las respuestas, por favor?
Sí,
que solo alcancé a escuchar bien dos, porque se me está yendo el internet.
No, no hay problema. Let's, se la voy a escribir en el chat, so you can keep them as well.
Okay.
Number two says, how is he...
Thank you.
Dividing, you're so welcome. How is he dividing the groups? The groups. I'm going to write them in the chat so you can take a look at this one. The other is, when is she handing the checks? When is she handing the checks? The other one is, which factory? Which factory is your boss visiting, etc. And the number in number five is, why is the new secretary secretary working next Saturday? Why is the new secretary working the next Saturday?
Porque no veo el chat. No lo veo.
Oh, sorry, my bad. Sorry, sorry, sorry. Lo mandé privado. Permítame un segundo. Give me a second. I was very excited texting here. ¿Me confirmas si lo ve? Let me know if you can see.
Sí, this. Ahora sí. Gracias.
Ah, okay. There you go. Okay. Okay, thank you. I was sending to another person there. Okay, guys. So, do you have any questions so far in this part? Igual, vamos a practicar. We are going to practice this as much as we can. So, si alguna pregunta sale, well, we are going to go for this. Okay, everybody, let's take a look at exercise number five. It says here, think of some future events of your classmates. Write five questions to ask your classmate about those events. Pensemos un poquito como en lo que viene del año, right? November, December, January, next year. So, ¿qué es lo que van a hacer, all right? Where are you spending your vacation? When are you going out of the country? Why are you, I don't know, why are you looking for a new job? So, pensemos un poquito en algunas preguntas que podamos hacer y escribamos cinco, right? Five questions to ask your classmate about future events, all right? So I'm gonna give you some time. Let's start working on them. But I think it would be better, guys, si lo hacemos en grupo. We are going to do this as a group. And if you pay attention here, hay una parte que dice your classmate. Vamos a escribir como la respuesta, right? The answer of the questions, the answer of your classmate. So, vamos a hacer esto en grupo. I think it's easier, you know, and better. So, give me one second. Voy a hacer grupos pequeñitos. I'm going to make some small groups. And so, creemos algunas preguntas. Let's try to ask some questions. And also, cuando ya terminan las preguntas, entrevístense, right? Provide your answers as well. And let's practice as much as we can. as much as possible. Give me one second. Okay. Okay. Okay, everybody, let's go for it. You got 10 minutes only. So let's go work on the questions. Solo son 5 preguntas, 5 questions. So everybody, let's go ahead.
No sé si como somos 4, podemos hacer de que, de que se pregunten 2 y 2.
Uh-huh. Ok, perfecto.
Que yo lo hago con usted, Sandra, y Verónica con Milagro.
Ok, solo déjeme terminar entonces. Vamos a... ¿O ya las, ya las hizo usted? No.
No, tampoco.
Ah, vaya, vamos a hacer...
I'm working and celebrating Christmas with my family. Yeah.
Yeah.
In my house.
In my house.
Vaya, ahí ya tengo la primera. No sé quién más tiene pregunta.
No. Para...
teacher, y si yo digo, when is your birthday?
¿Cuándo es su cumpleaños?
The question is good, Sandra. I mean, it's not wrong or anything. Pero la idea es utilizar futuros, right? Como eventos a futuro. Uh-huh. Entonces, tal vez sería como, when is...
Organized
¿cómo vas a
celebrar?
Party? ¿Cómo podría ser, dicho? When are you... Uy, when are you celebrating your birthday?
Exactly, exactly. I was thinking in something like that. Okay. Tal vez no como cuándo es, pero cuándo lo vas a celebrar. So when are you celebrating your birthday? Uh-huh. That sounds better.
Ah, yeah. When are you...
Avilen Celere una, when are you going to the beach? And you
Hey guys, guys, we don't have like too much time, so si tenemos algunas preguntas, let's start practicing with your classmates. Si todavía les faltan armarlas, no se preocupen, comparte las que tienen y practiquemos con esas, right? The idea is to practice, no terminar exactamente las 5 preguntas, right? So, everybody, let's start practicing. I'll give you like 3 more minutes. Let's go.
Okay.
Hello. Está hablando de nosotros. Where are we?
Where are we?
Doing.
Doing.
De ¿cuál era el complemento? Annual meeting. Annual meeting. Yeah.
La reunión, pongámosle. Doing the meeting.
Esta fue la última vez que
lo traducía como where do we
do. No sé, pregúntele a la teacher ya que está ahí si está bien.
Miss, una
consulta. Hi. Tell me.
O sea, teacher and question. Where do we do the end of the month meeting, the correct o no, o not?
En español, ¿cómo sería?
¿Dónde hacemos la reunión de fin de mes? O sea, de lugar, ¿ve?
Pero se refiere como a este otro mes, ¿verdad? ¿Dónde vamos a hacer la reunión?
Ajá.
Sí se puede. Sería como, where are we having the meeting? Doing the meeting. Where are we doing the meeting? Quizás en vez de doing sería como having. Where are we having the meeting? ¿A dónde vamos a tenerla? Where are we having the meeting next month?
Having.
Mm-hmm.
Where are we having the meeting?
Where are we having the meeting? ¿A dónde nosotros vamos a tener la reunión? Where are we? Mm-hmm.
Or, si yo digo,
where are you?
Mm-hmm. Si quieren nos escucha, teacher. Claro. Digo las preguntas, César, y yes. Así ella nos...
Okay.
Okay. What are you do next year with your family?
Okay, in the next year I go to Guatemala City in vacation.
Okay. Who are you visit the next month?
I go visit to my mother and my sister in San Miguel.
Okay. What do you have in the next vacation? Have. Okay. Tener. Así sería, teacher. ¿Qué harás en tu próxima vacación?
Sorry, solo léame la WH. Eso no le alcancé a escuchar.
What do you have in the next vacation?
Like, what do you have? Como, ¿qué vas a tener?
No, hacer. Entonces sería...
Ah, eso sería, what are you doing?
Sí.
Ajá, eso sí sería doing. Sí. En el caso de la meeting, porque se dice, yo tengo una reunión, I have a meeting. Ajá. Entonces, pero en ese caso, sí sería doing, porque ¿qué es lo que vas a hacer?
What are you doing in the next vacation?
Yes, that's good. What are you doing? Ajá.
Y la otra sería, where are you going? Ah, perdón.
In the next vacation, I'm painting my house.
Okay.
Yeah, that sounds
and
good.
Where are you going the January 1st?
I'm not going to any place. I am staying in my house.
Okay. And what are your colors picture the house in the next year? In the next year.
I am thinking painting green color.
Green color. Green.
Okay.
Thank you.
Green.
Green. Oh, green color.
Green.
Oh, you killed me. I was thinking green. So, ¿cuál es el color del viento?
Transparente.
My goodness. No, no, I mean, I don't know anything about colors. So, hay color es raro, you know. So, I was like, ¿cuál es ese color? I was about to, ya le iba a preguntar, you know. I was about to answer it, to ask you this. Okay, okay. Okay, guys, let's go to our meeting. Vamos a terminar and let's go to the other meeting.
Okay, thank you. Thanks.
Hi guys, so thank you very much for coming. Solo voy a robarles unos minutitos para el segundo control de asistencia. Así que me ayudan por favor with your camera and tell me present when I say your name. Hold on. Hold on. 3 and 4. Today is the 9th. Okay, so I got Isaac. Isaac, ¿ya está por acá? Are you with us?
Present.
Thank you, Isaac. I got Silvia. Silvia, are you here?
Present.
Thank you very much. I got Verónica. Sí, ¿verdad, Verónica?
Present.
Thank you, Berito. And Andrés. Andrés creo que todavía no ha entrado, right?
He's having problem with her connection.
He's having problems. Okay. Mm-hmm. So hopefully, ojalá los pueda resolver and he can join us. Okay, guys, thank you very much. ¿Cómo subieron sus preguntas? Was it difficult to make questions? ¿Estuvo fácil? Was it easy? Was it difficult? No mucho, not too much. A little. Okay, guys. Well, we are going to take a couple of minutes para practicar una de las habilidades que es bien importante y que because of the time no hemos podido practicar a lot. And this is reading. So we are going to practice reading comprehension. Reading comprehension, the ability, no se trata de entender cada palabra, sino entender una idea general. This is in your material, by the way. So here we have read the article about activities to keep employees happy. I have a question for you. ¿Qué los hace feliz? What makes you happy? Hablando del trabajo, right? Actividades que en el trabajo los hacen happy. What makes you happy?
When coworkers, uh-huh. When coworkers have a birthday.
Celebration. Yeah. Okay. So birthday celebration. Yeah. Okay. I love cake. So I'm like, I don't care about the birthday. I love food. No, okay, her song. Okay, so food, birthday, celebration.
When the company wire the
money on my account.
When the company, oh, when they pay you, payday.
Payday.
Okay, payday. Los 15 o los 30, you know, the end of the month. Okay, so payday. Guys, tell me, ¿qué los hacen feliz? I mean, what makes you happy? Hablando de, del trabajo, you know,
lean your company. Lean el comentario de Madeline.
Sí, muy que bien. Hace café. When she makes coffee, she says. No. Solo prepara el café. Madeline. Vacation. Okay, so vacation, food, celebration.
When I complete a sale.
When you complete.
When I complete a sale.
Because you get money. because you get commission. You get bonus.
Commission.
Okay, so you get bonus. Okay. Guys, y los demás, what about the others? What makes you happy?
Happy. The other people now.
The other people. Okay. Tell me, what makes you happy, guys? Yes. Hi. creo que se me quedó like frozen there.
¿Cómo se dice la convivencia en familia?
Sharing. Compartir. Oh. Sharing. I'm gonna write it in your chat. Okay, so compartir probablemente sharing with other guys, sharing with your coworkers. Okay. Ava, what makes you happy?
Sharing,
yes. Ava, what is something that makes you happy at the hospital?
Que salgan bien todas las cirugías.
That they survive.
When you say, save the patient.
When the patient survive. No, I mean, yes.
Que pasen, no problem.
That there is no complication, there is no issue, they get home, okay. Y lo más importante, that they survive. Yeah, okay. So that makes you happy. Aparte de eso, besides that part?
Doctor Days.
Doctor's Day celebrations, all right. Doris, what is something that makes you happy? Fatima, what makes you happy, girls?
Be with my family and celebrate my birthday.
Celebrate your birthday, be with your family. And talking about your work, hablando de su empresa, you know, something that you really like about your company? Something that makes you happy about your company?
Have my lunch with my coworkers.
Okay.
Because we love them.
Okay. Lunch with coworkers, okay. Fatima, Milagro, girls, what about you?
Vacation.
Celebration, fin de año.
Okay, December celebration. So December celebration, the party, the yearly party. Okay. Boys, let's listen to boys' opinion. We got Guillermo, we got Cesar, we got Isaac, Francisco, Christian. Well, we listened to her son already. Boys, what about you? ¿Es algo que los hace feliz in your workplace? Something that makes you happy? Sister, commission. Guillermo, I'm sorry. A job well done. Okay. But that make you happy?
Yeah.
Okay.
I like it. It is satisfactory.
Okay. All right.
That's my job.
When organizing excursion with my
Trips. Okay, you go to the beach or you travel. Okay, trips with your team. That's okay. A job well done. The satisfaction of completing something. Okay. Anything else? So there are like certain small things, okay, that companies do. Algunas empresas hacen cosas like trips, you know, like birthday celebration, etc. Para que los employees, o sea, as, you know, we are like super happy. And also because they want to, you know, create a really good environment. So tenemos esta lectura que es, you know, it's about these things. For example, we have here organized yoga classes, celebrate birthdays, paintball. ¿Alguien ha jugado paintball? Have you ever played paintball?
No.
No?
No.
But I would like.
But you would like. Yes, Isaac. Isaac has an emoji there. Okay. Guess who? That is also another game. Okay. So we are going to listen. No, Madeline says no, but
Madeline too.
Yeah, I really want to. I really want to. Dicen que deja moretes and everything, but I would love to. I really want to play this. So let's take a look at this reading about some activities that the companies do. Vamos a discutirles en, you know, in small groups, cuál es la que consideran que es mejor in a company, okay? Which of these activities do you think is the best for a company? Which ones do you like? And which ones you don't like, all right? So, le pueden tomar captura o está en el manual, so you can go for your manual as well, there's no problem. And read it, guys, leámoslas como grupo, try to read it as a group. Try to discuss it y determinen cuál es la que les gusta más, the one, only one that you really like, only and one that you and said why. No. Mm-hmm. And why, in and English, why I, in why, English, okay. Guys, yes, in English. So, okay. Ayudémonos de los compañeros para crear una razón de why una les gusta más. What is the reason? So, let's go ahead. Okay, everybody, let's go there. Escojan solo una. Choose only one and why.
Teacher.
Hola, Milagro, estoy leyendo ahorita su mensaje. No se preocupe, Miss, no se preocupe. Si, you know, puede quedarse solamente escuchando, don't worry.
Okay.
It's totally fine. Si necesita apagar la cámara un momentito, esa vez, no worries. Thank you so
¿Puedo?
Much.
¿Puedo hacerlo?
Sí, no se preocupe, okay. Missy. Espero que todo esté súper bien.
Gracias, teacher.
No worries. Hello, Silvia.
simple, or nothing special occasion can have a big impact. In short, your tenta you care about these people, know who's the employer. Get about.
Son más retiros espirituales que otra cosa.
Teacher, vamos a leer todo en alto, yes, o a cada una.
Lo pueden leer, lo pueden leer. No es necesario que lo lean en voz alta, right? Pero lo pueden ir leyendo como por pedacitos, preguntándose a las compañeras para que sea más rápido, preguntándose de alguna palabra que no entienden, you know. Por ejemplo, at the very, creo que sale así más fácil. I mean, that's for me. For example, the first part says, if you work in an office and your employees are sitting at a computer all every day, don't underestimate the impact yoga could have on their attitude and outlook. Entonces, por ejemplo, para mí una palabra nueva puede ser sitting, que es underestimate, que es outlook. Solo podemos compartir, podemos buscar una palabra cada una y luego le compartimos, mire, sitting es esto, underestimate es esto, outlook es esto, para que podamos irlo haciendo al mismo tiempo, you know, y vayamos socializando. I think it's better. Y al final discutimos cuál es la mejor, okay, which is the best.
Ok, thank you. Okay. Sitting.
Elegir un lugar para llevar a nuestros empleados. Los vamos a llevar a clases de yoga. Está bien. Para que se relajen.
Vaya, está bueno.
Teacher, ¿está ahí?
Yes, I'm right here.
¿Qué es lo que íbamos a hacer, teacher?
Vamos a leer la descripción que tenemos, right? So vamos a leerlo rapidito y vamos a escoger una de ellas que consideremos es la mejor actividad para mantener a nuestros empleados happy. En otras palabras, a nosotros mismos happy.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So, por ejemplo, ahí tiene yoga, paintball, tiene celebrate birthdays, pero de esos vamos a escoger solo una. Por ejemplo, como grupo creemos que paintball es la mejor actividad que puede mantener a todos los empleados happy, pero en inglés, claro, right? Porque les ayuda a socializar, interactúan, crean trabajo en equipo. ¿Verdad, Gabilena?
Son como capacitaciones.
No, son como distracciones.
Son distracciones.
Son distracciones para llevar a los empleados. O que nos lleven a jugar el paintball.
Exactly.
O que nos celebren los cumpleaños, o que nos den clases, yes, de yoga.
En la mayoría de compañías, hasta este momento, you know, están buscando como opciones para que el empleado siempre sea feliz y de lo mejor, uh-huh, right? Entonces, de esas actividades que las compañías pueden hacer, ¿cuál consideran ustedes que es la mejor? ¿En cuál de ustedes se sentirían mejor? Celebrando cumpleaños, creo que decía hay clases de yoga, so creen que funcionaría clases de yoga, paintball, guess who, jugar de vez en cuando como un jueguito entre todos, what do you think? So escogemos una, you are going to choose why.
Amigo secreto.
Ah, exactly, so I mean, no está acá, pero por supuesto podríamos incluir those type of activities, so vamos a escoger una y por qué, ese por qué lo vamos a explicar en inglés como grupo. So oh, I'll give you, okay, yes. Son 5 minutos, terminamos de leerlo, you know, o escojamos una y you tell me why, right?
O sea, lo que vamos a decir en inglés es el por qué elegimos eso.
Yes.
Ah, ok. Vaya, chicos, ¿ya escucharon?
Yes, let's work on it.
Ok. No se encuentro tan estresada. Ok, vamos con la segunda.
Celebrate birthday.
Ajá. Rely.
Boots.
Rely. ¿Qué es rely? Rally. Se escribe. Rally.
Mm-hmm. Rely.
Rely.
Yes. Rely.
¿Qué es rely?
Ah, tell me. I'm waiting for you. No, leamos el contexto, leamos lo que dice. Rely. ¿Qué más dice? What else?
To rally a business game.
Permítame.
Están en celebrate birthday.
Celebrate birthday. You don't have to rely on business games to boost morale. Okay, so it says there that you don't have to rely on business games. Normally, las empresas hacen juegos, but you don't have to rely on games, yeah? So no es necesario como mucha confiar. Competencia. Rely. Depender. Mm-hmm. Depender, exactly. So rely es como confiar en algo, depender de algo, you know, o creer que esto va a funcionar. So that is rely. It says to boost morale. Remember that la idea es que la empresa tiene que hacer algo para que nosotros nos sintamos cómodos. We feel happy and we say, oh, I love this company, you know. Para que Sandra diga, I love Champagnat. Nunca me voy a ir de ahí. That is the idea, right? So yeah. We have to be happy. Mm-hmm. Yes. So,
no, el ambiente es muy bueno, muy bueno.
Exactly. I mean, that is the point, that is the point. Vero, where do you work, Vero? Oh, pero
porque
quedó frisada.
Saca de la rutina.
Ah, okay. So what type of activities pueden
funcionar, right? It's out to the routine.
Mm-hmm. That is important, that the company does other type of activities. For example, que hagan trips. Ooh, that's a lot, you know. So that's super nice. Some companies take you to the beach. They take you to...
Interiors. Program interiors.
Theaters.
Interiores.
Ah.
Programas de interioridad. Ajá.
Oh, like, how do you call that one? Like intelligence, like emotional intelligence and all those things. Oh, okay. That sounds good. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Or they do some camping trips. So.
Not necessary. The salon and salon
in a room
and the room mm-hmm. practice
okay
exercise and the yoga class.
Oh, you got yoga classes. Nice. Oh, that's good. Vero, what about in your company? ¿Qué hacen? Jenny, what about in your company? What does your company do?
When they finish the production, when go to the trip to the pool. Hacen partidos de fútbol.
Oh, that's nice. I would really love to play soccer again. I haven't played like in 10 years. Berito, díganos algo. Tell us something.
Me escuchan.
Yes.
Yes.
Pero yo no las escucho a ustedes. No sé qué.
El internet está malísimo.
El internet está lento.
Está súper mal. Desde la tormenta está así. Bueno, desde hace 2 días está así. Yo dando la clase y yo sola dando la clase. Me sacó de la clase y yo sola.
You said you are very excited to express to class.
Repeat.
And that's a problem. We get excited. No. Yo no les escucho. Pero sí les escucho. No, pero igual no me escucha. So I'm going to send her a message. Yeah, probablemente sea el internet, right? So, a mí de repente se me queda frisado todo and I'm like, oh, I'm talking to myself. I don't know what's going on. But anyways, Vero, me escucha. Can you hear me? I think she doesn't. Creo que tiene lagging. Well, girls, and mientras tanto, you can continue. That's okay. Mientras ella logra solucionar el problema. Ok, second. I was texting her, you know.
Más rápido.
Yes, I know. Okay, better. Intente okay. Ahora. Try now.
No, ahora no, no la escucha, dice.
Pero ahora no.
Pero ni siquiera le escuchamos a ella.
Pero se está moviendo. En teoría el internet sí funciona, ven.
El audio, entonces, algo le está fallando.
Ahorita sí se me quedó.
Okay. ¿Sí?
¿Nos escucha? Sí. ¿Can you listen to us? Ahora nosotros sí. No la escuchamos. Solo la vemos. Ok, déjame ver. Let me see. What
cosa.
Ah, sí, ya lo escuché.
Ah, ya está. Audífono, ya está.
Ya logré escucharlas.
Sí, es el internet.
Pero quitándolo ya no las escucho. Ustedes no me escuchan a mí.
¿Y si quita el video?
Ahorita sí la escuchamos. Ahorita sí la escuchamos, pero...
Guess who? Guess who? Jennifer, comprende la 4.
Ya lo metí al traductor.
Okay.
Es que no entendí una palabra, entonces.
¿Y de qué trata? Definitivamente ayuda. La vida espiritual, dice Andrew.
No.
Podemos agregar alguna de
agregamos lo que habían dicho ustedes primero.
Hi, guys. I'm just coming here, you know, checking on you. A ver cómo están. ¿Necesitan más tiempo? Do you need more time?
Unos minutitos.
Yes.
Okay, okay. I'll check on you in 2-3 minutes.
Nos quedamos así. We chose the paintball activity because it that relaxes us and we have a chance to positive the boss. It's very exciting.
Yeah.
¿Cómo así?
Yes.
Okay.
Con bolas de pintura roja.
Hi, I was just checking on you si necesitaba más tiempo, but I think you are ready, right?
Yes. We are ready.
You're ready. Okay, good. So in the meantime, seleccionen a una persona, select the person, so you can practice and you can present to everybody, right? De preferencia, si no lo lees, sería super awesome. Okay. So I'll give you like 2 more minutes mientras el resto de grupos terminan también. So let's go on. Seleccionen a su, you know, to your speaker.
Okay, muchas gracias por ofrecerse, don Guillermo.
Inside the office is false. False. Because it's out of the office.
Hi, guys. Good evening.
This is true.
So, I was just like checking on you. Solamente estaba revisando here, como les estaba yendo. If you need more time, remember that the idea of this activity es leerlas todas, read it, analyze it, comprender ideas generales, and seleccionar una y por qué. So you have to select one and explain why in English, okay? So I'm coming here, guys, porque necesito que seleccionen una persona, select one person to represent the group y que nos explique a todos why you selected that one. Si lo pueden hacer sin leerlo, sería super, super awesome, okay? So I'll give you like 2 more minutes, escojan a una persona and practice sin leerlo, please. Try to explain it with your own words.
Okay, nice. Teacher,
tell me.
We answer the 1 to 5 question, the true and false. It's okay.
Esta cosa no sé por qué me ponen mute. Yes, that's super nice. Esa es la siguiente actividad.
Okay.
That is the next
activity. Ah, sorry.
No, you're fine. You're fine. Ya adelantaron, so you're good.
Okay, no problem.
Escojamos a una persona. Select a person. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Democráticamente o dedocráticamente. Herstal.
César, iba a decir yo.
Thank you so much for coming back. Solo esperamos al resto de compañeros that they can join us. And so, in general, the idea was, vamos a leer, we are going to read the whole thing. Hay palabras que van a ser nuevas, you know, pero no es necesario que entendamos todas las palabras. The most important thing is que entendamos la idea general. So this was, there were some proposals like celebrations, había también play paintball, guess who, in the yoga classes, okay, para que nosotros estemos felices in a company. So I want you to choose one. Quiero que escojan una. I want you to choose one and tell us, guys, por qué escogerían esa. Why you choose that one, okay? So why do you think it is the best option? I asked you guys before que escogieran un voluntario. So choose a volunteer or choose a representative of each of the groups. So no sé si tengo like volunteers o escojo. I choose the people. Any volunteer? O selecciono. Do I choose?
No hay voluntario.
Avilene? Well, yo veo que Avilene is ready. Avilene, let's go. Go, girl, go.
Vaya, nosotros escogimos con Francisco, Milagro y Madeline.
Uh-huh.
Tema número one, organize yoga class.
Okay.
We believe yoga class are very relaxed.
Okay.
Because the person are relaxing in the class.
Okay.
Yoga class helps staff to have inner peace. We think the yoga class is best for the personal because can help alleviate stress, calm the mind, relax tension.
Hey, very nice. That was super good. Very good explanation. So yoga can help you relax, can give you peace, inner peace, can help you relieve stress. Oh, I like the emojis. Very nice. Thank you, Avilena. Thank you for sharing this with us. Group, that was a very nice insight from you. Another volunteering group. Okay, so let me go with Ada's group. Ada's group, who is your representative?
Hace falta la ruleta, teacher.
Yes, I know, but we cannot use the roulette. Vamos más con voluntarios o víctimas.
Okay. Like,
I'm gonna. Oh, Gerson, go.
Okay, the other groups is Gerson and
it's Gerson.
And Silvia. And Silvia and me.
Okay. Okay, guys, go.
Okay, we like celebrate birthday because we eat a lot of cake, a lot of drinks, and drink coffee or juice or water for the people have a sugar in the blood. But the most important for the person is the birthday. And the people celebrate the life, the new year life. I don't say, and
it's okay.
The staff is very, the staff have a funny time with the boss, with the old team, and this is it.
Nice, thank you very much. That's a different point of view. So that is celebrating birthdays. Nice, I really like your insight. So we really like birthdays. We enjoy eating cake, sugar, you know, sandwich. I love sandwich. Yeah. And everything that you can get.
Party sandwich, party, right? Party sandwich.
So, yeah, or pizza. Have you heard about the pizza party? So you can have a party of pizza. That's super good. Okay, thank you guys. That was a very nice one. Guillermo, I believe you were the representative of the other group, right?
Okay.
They chose you.
Our group, we stay Doris, Isaac, Santa Beatriz, Fatima, and me. We chose the paintball activity because it is that relaxes us and we have a chance to punch in the balls. It is relaxed, it is very adrenaline, is exciting. That's it.
Thank you. That's a very nice description. So that was paintball, right? So thank you, Guillermo. That's a, you know, it's very interesting because you have different activities. That's a very good one. Thank you. Okay, guys, I am missing one group, and the last group is going to be Jennifer, Sandra, and Veronica. Girls, let's go.
Ok, fue una decisión personal, teacher. Cada quien escogió uno. Ok,
that's fine.
A mí, organize yoga class. We take away the routine because health a convivence and help alleviate stress, calm the mind, and release tension.
All right, so in your case, it is yoga classes, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. What about the rest of your classmates? Veronica, do you agree with Sandra? Do you have the same? Do you have something different? Jennifer, what do you think about this? Do you have the same opinion as Sandra?
¿Me escucha?
Ahorita sí, Jennifer, ya, ya te lo escucho.
No, soy yo.
Ah, Verónica.
Sí, pero ahorita sí lo escuchamos. Go, go, go.
Because celebrate birthday, because get everyone to sing a car. Have a cake. Simply a call waiting special occasion.
Okay, so that's a different one, celebrating birthdays. Thank you, Veronica. And yes, this is a very special occasion. Thank you. So everybody has a different point of view on this, and this is super good. So there is no right or wrong answer. And I really like it because you are giving explanation. Now, guys, let's take a look at the following exercise basado en la lectura. So here we have. Answer the following questions about the reading. Yoga has an important effect on employees. True or false? What do you think? Or what do you... O si ya las completaron, so tell me. What is your opinion on this? What is the answer?
True.
Okay. Yeah, it is true. ¿Alguien ha jugado yoga? Have you jugado? Have you ever done yoga?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it good?
Yes. Yes.
Do you recommend difficult. It? Difficult. Yes. So I did it well.
The position.
Super recomendado.
Really? It's very interesting because I did it once y me caí. So, like, no, that's not my thing. Okay, okay, so that could definitely work. So that is true. Two, yoga releases tension, but it doesn't calm the mind.
False.
¿Qué dice la lectura? What does the reading say?
True.
The yoga can help alleviate stress, calm the mind, release tension, improve brain and lift mood.
Okay, exactly. So, sí ayuda. It releases tension and also it calms your mind. Yeah, so that is exactly. That is false. Porque sí la calma. Three, based on the reading, spatial locations are not important. True or false?
False.
False,
because the reading says spatial locations are important, right? So they are super important. Number four, workers can play paintball inside the office. True or false?
False.
Totally false. Yeah, totally false. Yeah. And number five, childhood photos can offend employees. True or false?
False.
False?
False.
No. Often. ¿Qué es often, teacher?
Often. Ooh.
Offender.
Oh, often. Oh, this one, offend. Childhood photos can offend employees. Let's take a look. It says, ask everyone to bring a childhood photo themselves and put up on a board. And then get everyone to put their best guesses forward on each one. It's a bit of easy, lighthearted fun that will definitely help lift a spirit while offering plenty of humor along the way. Menciona algo que ofende. Is it offensive?
No.
No, right? Because it says it can offer humor. So en realidad es lo opuesto, yeah? So this can be like super good. So the answer is no. Childhood photos cannot offend employees. Okay, guys. So based on this, vamos a hacer lo siguiente. We are going to do the following. De la lectura, vamos a trabajar en grupos y quiero que escojan 5 palabras nuevas. 5 words that you learn from the reading. Okay. Cualquier palabra que haya sido nueva that you didn't know. All right. And for example, something new for me can be release or boost. Or let me see any other word that can be new, can be, for example, guess. Okay. Plenty.
So, yes. Esa palabra de la lectura número 2, ¿cómo se pronuncia?
This word.
Donde dice así. No, donde dice people acknowledging.
Simply acknowledging spatial locations. What is acknowledging? Que su jefe venga y le diga, hey, sé que te pasó esto, felicidades, you know? Sé que pasaste un examen, congratulations. Te moviste de casa, congrats. Acknowledging es que se dé como por enterado, all right? So that they acknowledge. O cuando usted hace un buen trabajo. Yes, tell me.
Como reconocimiento.
Exactly. Pero no necesariamente dinero, right? I mean, there are different ways to acknowledge something. Que usted hizo, por ejemplo.
Only a moral.
No, for example, Guillermo dijo antes que hacer un buen trabajo me hace bien. For example, when you do a good, when you complete or you have done a very good job, y su jefe viene y le dice, hey, you did it, you know, that was super good. So, eso es acknowledge, okay? And to tell you, you did it nicely. Acknowledge. Acknowledging. Mm-hmm.
So, mm-hmm.
Sure.
Yes.
Trying, el que dice en el número 3 al final, que dice prime target.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Perdón. Prime is the most important.
The most important.
Yes, the most important target. Mm-hmm. Okay, guys. So, tenemos...
La palabra target, teacher.
Oh, target.
Como blanco. Yeah. El blanco.
Exactly. When you shoot, it's like you have a target. So, oh. You say, I want to get there. That's your target. Mm-hmm. So, look, because of the time, let's do something. We won't be able to complete the conversation. Pero de las 5 palabras, escribamos una oración utilizándola. Podemos usar la lectura como referencia, pero no copiar y pegar, right? Tampoco de Google, guys. try to come up, okay, with a sentence using the words. Tenemos 4 or 5 minutes, okay? Y luego nos vamos. Guys, no se me desconecten, please. Don't leave yet. Ok, nos vamos hasta que cada uno va a presentar un ejemplo super quick. Dígame, César.
What is themselves? Themselves.
Ellos mismos. Number 4. Themselves. Ellos mismos.
Themselves. Okay.
Ellos mismos. Guys, thank you very much for your attendance this week. Ha sido super, super nice. And ya casi terminamos, you know, así que un último esfuerzo, that would be super good. Please, me ayuden el día de ahora completando las actividades de la parte número 3, de la sección número 3. Así mañana ya no los estoy molestando, you know. I'm not sending... No los molesten su día libre. And what else, what else, what else? Gracias por la puntualidad. Eso es bien importante. Remember that INSAFORP está monitoreando no solamente que usted se conecte, sino el tiempo de conexión también. Si usted está a los 120 minutos, you know, si está solo 10 minutos y luego se desconecta. Entonces, les agradezco enormemente por el apoyo con eso. Ha sido un grupo súper fuerte, you know, súper punctual. Así que, thank you so, so much for that. Creo que le comentaba por ahí algunos. Guys, cuidamos a su grupo, you know. Take care of your group. Acabemos 16 ahorita, nos faltan 4. But esperemos que todos los 20 lleguen al nivel número 3. Y esto siga hasta que lleguen al nivel número 20, right? So take care of each other. That's super important. Try to connect every single day on time, you know. Para que no haya ningún tipo de dificultad al final, para que obtengan también su reconocimiento, your acknowledging from INSAFORP. You got like 2-3 more minutes. No sé si necesitan más tiempo. Do you need more time? Did I distract you from talking? Solo son 5 palabras. Only 5 words. Si tienen más, no hay problema. You can make more examples. More sentences.
Teacher.
Yes.
Aquí en el number 1, mm-hmm. Veo la palabra que estuvimos viendo ayer, lift.
Ah, yes.
Lift move.
¿A dónde está? Es que no la veo. I don't
al
see
final,
the word.
El number 1.
Oh, lift. ¿Se recuerda que era lift? Do you remember the meaning of lift?
Sí, es levantar.
Exactly. Lift, levantar el ánimo.
Levantar o...
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that is left the moon. Okay, everybody, so we are going to get started. Necesito solo una oración, only one example of your own, okay? And everybody will do that. So Guillermo, usted es mi primer, the first person of my screen. So let's go, one example, please.
Teníamos que hacer una oración con una de las palabras que no conocíamos, ¿verdad?
Sí, exactly,
no.
Exactly, yes.
Okay. my childhood photos. I don't have mm-hmm. photos for the, my childhood mm-hmm. because they stolen.
Ah, they were stolen, really? The photos. Okay. Yeah. So, so Guillermo, la palabra nueva era childhood.
Childhood.
Uh-huh. Okay, got it. Thank you. Okay, nice. And it's very interesting that they were stolen. Thank you, Guillermo. Avilena, you are my second person here.
No,
okay, don't worry. Ya regreso con usted, no problem. ¿Quién tiene la siguiente? Who's got another one? Ava, are you ready, Ava?
My boss at the Anschorst Landing, algo así dice, o cómo se pronuncia. La segunda simple action
acknowledging
uh-huh. The various events mm-hmm. only know solo celebration.
Ah, okay. So they are acknowledging a lot of them. Thank you, Ada. That's a good one.
Okay, hay otras fechas importantes, no solamente una fecha de cumpleaños.
Not only the birthday. Logro. Exactly. Uh-huh. So they acknowledge different events. Thank you. That's a good one. So Madeline is sharing here, I guessed the sentence. Very nice, Madeline. So guess, I believe. Herzog, are you ready?
Yeah. It's you never underestimate your enemy.
Oh, very good. Don't underestimate your enemy. Okay, thank you. Cesar, you ready?
Yeah, miss.
Mm-hmm. Go. Shoot.
I don't underestimate the other people because uh-huh. they have a lot
of experience.
Knowledge.
Yes, very good. I like it. Thank you, Cesar. Doris, ready?
Yes. In my work, my boss and my co-workers give an acknowledging mm-hmm. and a gift for me because I am celebrating my birthday, for example.
Okay, that's a good sentence. Thank you, Doris. Sandra Beatriz. Go, Sandra.
Teacher, mi internet me sacó, yo solo una alcancé.
No se preocupe, tell us what you have. Sacar. No worries.
Okay, my childhood was uh-huh. wonderful.
Ay, nice, okay. So childhood creo que es la nueva, right? Nice. Sandra Patricia, there you go.
Childhood.
Se me acabó la batería. Low battery y salí corriendo a traerla. Okay, pero sí hice una.
Okay, nice. Please, go, no problem.
The Target is the cool store.
Okay, so the Target. Okay, I believe Target is the new one. Thank you, that's good. Milagro, mm-hmm. do you have your example? Vero, ready yes. now? Okay, yes. Milagro, go, let's go with you.
La palabra que elegí fue themselves.
Ah, themselves, okay.
Themselves. Y yo escribí in the afternoon, mm-hmm. the game was between themselves. Mm-hmm. It that's was okay. fun.
Okay, that's good. The game was between themselves, entre ellos mismos. Yes, very nice. Veronica, let's go with you.
My boss congratulations me on my birthday at Boots My Happiness.
Ay, nice. I like it. That's a very good use of the word boost. Okay, thank you. Fatima, you ready?
The yoga alleviate stress.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so yoga alleviate. Okay, stress. That's a very good one. Okay, everybody. So I believe we are done. Thank you so much, everybody, for your participation. Thank you for coming today. I'll be seeing you on Monday. Enjoy your weekend. Y ayúdenme con la tarea, please. Help me along with the homework. Bye-bye, everyone. Ahora sí, you can go. Bye, everyone. Good night.
Bye.
Good night. Bye.